Hey, let's do some debugging today. Students often have trouble debugging their programs, but things can get especially difficult when we have multiple threads involved. And lately I've been talking a lot about threads, creating threads, manipulating threads, multi-threaded programming, and some of you have asked for some help with debugging these programs, and so today I thought we would look at how we could go about debugging a multi-threaded program. Now for today's video, I'm assuming a few things. I'm assuming that you have a basic understanding of threads and of the pthreads library, and I'm also assuming that you have some basic understanding of how to use GDB to debug programs. If that's not the case, I've got a bunch of videos that can help. Just pause this video. I'll link to a bunch of those videos in the description. Go watch those and then come back, and this will make a whole lot more sense. So for today's video, we're going to look at the last example from my last video. This example has two threads. One counts to a billion, and one uses a socket to go out and download a web page. Pretty simple, but it's a useful example. Okay, so let's load our program into GDB and try to trace its execution. So let's break at the start of main. We'll get it started. Okay, right here we find ourselves at the point at which our example creates the second thread. Now when I use the next command to step along the main thread, you notice that the counter increases because each time I run the next command, the new thread that I had created, the other thread, is run for a while and then it stops when the main thread stopped. The thing is, when I keep running it, you see different behaviors, like different amounts of execution. And this is one reason why you might get confused when you're debugging multi-threaded programs, is that you have one thread that you seem to have control over and the other thread that just kind of does whatever it wants. So what can we do? Okay, so the first thing we can do is use the info threads command, which that shows us what threads are running and which thread we're currently stepping through. Okay, so this is helpful just to get a bearing for where we are. So I can see, in this case, I can see the main thread and the new thread that I created. I can see what line we're each on, and the asterisk tells me which one I'm currently debugging. Currently is like the current active one. Okay, so also note that GDB gives each thread a thread ID. And just in case you're wondering what LWP stands for, that stands for lightweight process, which is just another name for threads. And I can change which thread I'm stepping through by using the thread command and just give it the ID for the thread I want. So now I'm on thread one, now I'm on thread two, and now I can step through the code in thread two. So this gives me a little more control over the threads that I'm stepping through, but you notice that I'm still jumping into the threads at arbitrary points in time. So typically when I'm debugging a multi-threaded program, I also stick breakpoints at key points, either at the beginning of the thread function or at the point in the thread function that I actually want to debug, that I actually care about. And that way I know that it's not going to get beyond that point and I'm going to have an opportunity to switch over into that new thread. So in this example, I might set a breakpoint at the start of the count to big function. That's my thread function. So I just set a breakpoint right there. And so then I get stopped right at the beginning. And now I can see basically from the beginning what happens in that thread. And of course, this function does count a lot. So let's say that there's something interesting that happens when the counter reaches 4,500 or some arbitrary number. So if that's the case, then I can use a watch point to stop whenever the counter reaches 4,500. And this will stop execution regardless of which thread actually incremented that counter and which thread caused it to reach 4,500. It's just basically gonna watch that value, and any time that it reaches 4,500, it's gonna stop us just like this. And that's really useful if I have a program that has a bunch of different threads that are each manipulating memory, and I'm not really sure how I'm getting to the point that I'm getting to. Some value gets written to a certain variable and I don't know how it got there or which thread wrote it there or what's going on. I can just use a watch point and it's going to stop execution whenever that happens, and I can look around and see what state each of my threads are in. Okay, so I can also set breakpoints that are specific to a single thread. In this case, you just use the break command like you would normally, but you add the word thread and the thread ID you want at the end. GDB also lets me apply a command to multiple threads. Okay, so the most common reason that I use this is if I want to see a stack trace for all my threads. I can just type thread apply all BT or backtrace. I could write out the whole backtrace command if I want, and that's going to be like me calling backtrace on every single one of my threads. And this is super useful if I'm not really sure where I'm at, I've just stopped at a watch point or a breakpoint, and I just want to get a snapshot of what's going on in my program at that time. I can just get a backtrace on all the threads, see what function they're in and how they got there, and that's super useful. Now this thread apply all works for any command, it's not just backtrace. Like I could use it for printing out the stack frames or navigating the call stack or anything like that. Basically any command, this will just apply that command to all the different threads. And I'm sure I'm missing a command or two, but this is how I debug multi-threaded programs in GDB. Just a few commands. They allow me to switch between threads. They allow me to inspect each thread and set watch points and breakpoints. And so I can stop at key points during my program's execution. And that's it for today, short and simple, but I hope it's useful. I hope this helps you on your next multi-threaded program to find your bugs more quickly and know that you've got a few tools that not everybody knows about in GDB that can help make your debugging process less painful and faster. And so until next time, happy coding, and I'll see you soon.